from the company Sonestar I got this 3D printer named M8R2. The design of the mechanics of this extremely low priced filament printer is more or less based on the Prusa i3. A large community grew over the years around printers of this type, so there are gigabytes of files available enabling tinkerers to upgrade hard and software of the M8R2. This machine ships as a kit with only a few components being pre-assembled, so that it is great for people that want to understand how filament printers work. In other words, the M8R2 is the right printer for people like me. The frame is made of 1.5mm steel panels and two extruder motors forward 1.75mm filament into one hot end. With this 2-in-1 concept you can print objects in two different colors using one type of plastics. The build instruction is on the SD card that ships with the printer. It's not in perfect English, however the numerous drawings are self-explanatory. I needed 6 hours for the assembly and I took many pictures and recorded a couple of video sequences in that time as well. Have a look at those pictures on my pages if you run into trouble during the assembly of your printer. In this video I will make just a few remarks. When mounting the belt of the Y axis I have loosened the pulley first, mounted the belt with relatively good tension using the cable straps, and finally re-tightened the pulley to get a perfect tension. The guiding rods of the X axis are not screwed on the plastic mounts and the left side is open, which is, as you can see, no perfect solution. The insulation of the terminals of the mains voltage is insufficient. Same is for the power supply, a type often used in cheap printers. Additionally, the power switch is a bit hidden and close to the terminals of the mains voltage. My advice is to leave it in on position and use a switchable socket, with that you can turn off the printer quickly in case something goes totally wrong. The wiring is done quickly, all motors and end switches have plugs with protection against reverse polarity and all cables are covered with fabric tubes. Heated bed and hot end are connected through screw terminals, however that's where polarity doesn't matter. Screw terminals are also used for the power supply of the mainboard, but here the wrong polarity will damage your printer immediately. Keep in mind that the black cable must be connected to ground, while the red cable is for the plus 12V line. After the assembly, you should check if you can move all axes smoothly by hand and if the end switches are triggered correctly. Especially the mechanics of the Y axis should not hit any of the cables. The printhead on the X axis is guided along the round bars by two linear bearings, each with a length of only 29mm, resulting in noticeable backlash. A longer bearing at the top would make things better. Nonetheless, the movement along the axis is very smooth. The Z axis is driven by two stepper motors through spindles, being guided by round bars with plastic bushes in the mounts of the X axis. The frame is made of steel plates, however the panels don't have the thickness of tanks. As a result, the construction bends noticeably at the top when applying side load. Put the printer on a flat surface, I'm using a 40x40cm floor tile. Make sure all corner points make contact to the ground, if not, loosen the screws and realign the frame correctly. Before turning the printer on for the first time, adjust the build plate to a low position. after turning the printer on. The info screen appears on the 20x4 characters LCD. The printer is controlled with a rotary switch. Because of the exposed position of that switch, the Teflon tube and cables can get entangled. A simple aluminum bar on top of the frame eliminates that source of error. The firmware offers a lot of adjustments. Here I'm choosing the printer test. First of all, the end switches are checked. After that, all axes are driven in either direction and finally the heating of print bed and hot end are turned on. If all tests ended successfully, you can adjust the printer. First thing to be done is bringing both ends of the X-axis to the same height over the Y-axis. Disable the stepper motors and turn the spindles by hand. You can either use a ruler to adjust the height or take a printed spacer, which is more comfortable. After homing all axes, you can start leveling the print bed. Unfortunately, there is no command in the firmware to drive the printhead to the corner points automatically. As usually, the height of the build plate is raised step by step. Until nothing but a sheet of paper fits tightly between nozzle and build plate. After preheating the hot end for PLA to 190 degrees Celsius, you can insert the filament by pushing a lever on the extruder motor. Inserting is a bit fiddly at the motor of the M8R2. Push in filament until a strand of plastics exits the nozzle. Even if you intend to print with only one color, you must insert filament at the second motor as well. The M8R2 ships with two small spools of filament, I got blue and black PLA. The print bed is heated, the maximum temperature you can adjust is 115 degrees Celsius. No more than 3 minutes are needed to reach 60 degrees Celsius, while 90 degrees are reached after 6 minutes. After 9 minutes, the temperature climbed to 100 degrees Celsius, which is more or less the maximum of the M8R2. The environmental temperature is 26 degrees Celsius. Print data is transferred through an SD card. The card reader is placed on the board of the LCD display on top of the printer, now the best position to reach from the front. Usually my advice is to use a file that comes with the SD card as a first test, however printing R2CAT.gcode simply did not work. That's why I have created my own two-tone test object. The color change appears in each layer, which is tricky to handle. When going from the extruder motor with the black filament to the one with the blue plastics, there is no rapid change in color on the nozzle. Not until all of the molten black plastics inside the hot end is squeezed out of the nozzle by the blue filament, the color change is done. You must design your object in such a way that the change in color happens while printing the inner structure so that the visible outer parameters are printed afterwards. It's tricky to design, but as you can see, it works fine with the labeled cuboid shown here. The change back from blue to black also needs a couple of millimeters of filament until it's done. After approximately 10 hours, the print of the 150x20x22mm cuboid is done. The blue characters are clearly visible on the black background. More simple to design and print are changes in color between layers. The orange and white traffic cone has the dimensions 88x88x60mm. Same as before, the change from orange to white doesn't happen immediately, however it's not that important where inside the layer it appears. The cone was printed after 2.5 hours. Colored prints is not what I need or have in mind, but those of you that are more talented in arts than I am, and that's for sure the majority of mankind, have lots of parameters to play with. With a maximum temperature of the print bed of more than 100 degrees Celsius, you get a good adhesion of ABS on the surface of the build plate. The box I'm printing here has a base area of 15x11cm. However, sticking on the build plate isn't all you have to fight when printing materials with a high rate of shrinking, you can see cracks between layers on the edges. If you do lots of prints in ABS, you should consider building an enclosure for the M8R2, which also helps fighting the bad smell of fumes evaporating from ABS while printing. The M8R2 can print smaller objects using ABS with no problem. The material of my choice is usually PLA, which is much more easy to handle. With the Zonestar M8R2 you get a working filament printer for only a few bucks. Considering the low price, you can't expect to get a perfect machine and you must be willing to upgrade the design by yourself. However, there are more expensive printers available that turn out to be imperfect out of the box as well. Improving a machine is part of the fun for all tinkerers like me. By upgrading the mechanics step by step, you get a deeper understanding of how a filament printer works, and the quality of the M8R2 can grow with your skills. Besides firmware experiments, the mainboard offers lots of free plugs for upgrading the electronics. There are interfaces for filament sensors, a second hot end or a distance sensor so that you can implement auto-leveling. Implementing a second hot end makes printing two color objects more easy and you can print different kinds of plastics in one run as well. I will upgrade my Zonestar step by step using printed parts as well as additional electronic parts and publish the progress on my pages, have a click to see what's going on. As you can see, the results out of the box are not bad, here I'm printing parts for a new robot. The overhangs at the tiny parts are really good, obviously the cooling fan works fine. A disadvantage of the 2-in-1 hot end is oozing, you can see lots of thin strings between the parts, however they are easy to remove after the print is finished. The overall print quality is not outstanding, but good. The chain links work as they come out of the printer and that's what counts in rapid prototyping. You can leave comments, here on YouTube or on my pages, to make suggests for upgrades of my Zonestar M8R2 and so become part of the design team. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.